Hi, I'm Mandy Kovacs with IT World Canada, and I'm here today at Technicity with Hillary Hartley, Ontario's Chief Digital Officer. Thanks for being here, Hillary.
Thanks, Mandy.
So you've been on the job for a couple months now, and we spoke a few months ago, and you were still getting the team together and setting up and doing all the housework. So what's changed now? What was your first order of business?
I am about 8 months in. It's been an exciting sort of summer and fall, heading into the winter here in Toronto. Yes, the first few months were really about kind of setting up the team and bringing a couple of teams together and figuring out how we were going to work on this change mission together and going through some of the bureaucratic maneuvers to make that happen as well. But the team has been really delivering on our mandate from day one, you know, even since before I got here. And really that's about how do we help the OPS think about approaching their services slightly differently. How do we help them approach it with a user-centered lens? Yes, we are going to create some digital products, but it's a bigger mission than that, and it's about really helping our partners in the ministries just kind of change the way they think about approaching their problems. So our first big three starting off have been we're a partnership with Service Ontario, a partnership with the Ministry of Health, and with the Ministry of Advanced Education and Skills Development, helping them with the Ontario Student Assistance Program transformation they've been going through. So it's been several exciting months, and the team continues to crank out good work around Ontario.ca, which is our, you know, the flagship website for the province, and we're proud stewards of that.
That's great.
Yeah.
Have you overcome any challenges along the way?
Personally, it's mostly just been about kind of getting the lay of the land as a newbie to Canada, to Toronto, to Ontario, to the Westminster model, kind of all of those types of things have been interesting to me in terms of just sort of comparing and contrasting to the way the U.S. federal government works, which is my most recent position, or you know, some of the states that I used to work with. At the end of the day, government is a big bureaucracy, and once you, it's sort of like I used to say, I used to live in New York City, so now I kind of understand subway systems. And I think, you know, once you work in a big bureaucracy, you kind of understand how they work. It's just getting to know the precisions of this particular one. So my team's been helping me through that. But that's really, those have been kind of the biggest challenges because I've been fortunate the team is so dedicated to what we're doing. And my peers are really supportive and excited about this work. So, you know, I'm sure there may be some to come, but it's been a great start.
Right. And have you identified any emerging technologies that you think will be crucial going forward with your mandate?
Well, you know, I think that there are some obvious ones that a lot of folks are talking about the potential of blockchain. They're talking about the potential of AI and machine learning. I am most interested kind of in the near term in just kind of figuring out how we work with and share data in a different way, both kind of between ministries and among government, but also with the public, and kind of what we do with that and the things that we build to enable that. The thing I talked a lot about when I was with the federal government in the US was kind of an API-enabled government, you know, an application programming interface. And if government focuses on what we can and should do, not only do then we enable, you know, sort of my team and other ministries to build on top of that kind of foundational plumbing work almost, but you can enable, you know, a vendor ecosystem, and you can enable nonprofits to serve their niche audiences. So those are some of the things I'm particularly interested in.
Well, that's great to hear. Thank you again for being with us today.
Thanks.
Once again, I'm Mandy Kovacs with IT World Canada.